today I'm going to talk to you about the jab. I've got a few video requests about how to do a jab properly, so I'm going to go through that. First thing you want to do is you want to make sure that you're in whatever stance you're going to be in. Basic boxing stance would be about a half step forward, half step out. Shift your weight about 45 degrees. Hands come up. You're going to cover your chin, cover your cheekbones. Be a little bit higher than you want. You want your elbows to be tucked in. Okay? And what's going to happen is when you throw that jab, it's going to be extension from, we're going to think about drawing a straight line from our shoulder to our target. So if our target is here, I want to draw a straight line to that target while rotating my fist. See, my waist is rotating, and you can actually also rotate with the foot to get a little bit of an extra distance. Look at the difference between here and here. That's the difference between barely touching somebody and smashing somebody in the face. So, weird. If you need to, you can actually add a little step too. So step, boom. And what you want to think about is as soon as that foot lands, as I'm making contact with the target, boom. And it wants to try to come back as quickly as it went out. So it's a very snappy punch. So that rotation, boom, back in. You can double it, boom, boom. You can high, you jab low by changing levels. As long as it's a straight punch, lead hand. So with the lead hand, I tell people to jab sometimes when they try to jab with their rear hand. This is your power hand. Lead hand is your distance and your timing. That's the point of the jab. So when you're jabbing, you're trying to figure out distance. Am I hitting? Am I close? I'm pawing a little bit. Punch, come back, punch, come back, and I can chase, or I can move in a circle. But the point of a jab is distance, timing, and setting up combinations. And that, make sure that it's not just your arm. You want to at least get your waist involved, and you can even get your hips involved when you turn that foot. The weight is on the ball of the foot right now, not on my toes. The weight is on the ball of my foot. And then as it comes back, everything rotates at the same time.